There's a couple of deer in here. I didn't see the first one. It wasn't a big animal though. Anyway, took the shot down through here. The second deer came out. It was honking down below me, and just down through here, and across that way. Raking shot into the right-hand shoulder, and she took off down into there somewhere. So we'll go down and have a look. These deer were fairly high up today. There's a cool change coming through. Saturday the 10th of April. I didn't see one deer grassing this morning from camp, so probably a kilometre back in those deer. Didn't put anything up at all on the way in. They're coming up pretty high. I want to get above them. Wind was all wrong. I still didn't hear anything take off in the way there. Plenty of dog sign near camp. Really fresh scat. He's probably been there yesterday afternoon or this morning, maybe. Maybe last night. Somebody's come down here in a hurry. That wasn't the one I shot. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Alright. Oh, a bit of blood there. Straight down through here. A bit of blood there. The blood's gone through there. There's a bit of blood, it's always good. He's in a bit of strife, he hasn't picked his path very well. Right. There she is. Good stuff. A bit deceiving, I thought she would have made it to the other side there, but no. We're watching them up above. Good eater anyway. Taken out the off side shoulder. Shot was probably 70, 80 metres, I suppose. You might see it in the footage, hopefully. Still kept going downhill.
Stag just knocking these trees down because they're going to get all over the moon as well. Beautiful mainline. Sure enough, if I put the ammo away, I'll see a bloody dog on the way out. Not that I'm going to be able to get a shot at it, but anyway. Carrying all this crap.
Been having a bit of a break here. And I was going through some video on the camera. And I was talking on the video so faintly, you can hardly hear it. Next minute, a big animal's taken off. Probably 50 metres below me is another game trail. I'd say he's come back. I've actually been sitting here howling for a while to see what happens. Whether he's just come up or coming back from the fringe. I don't know. Anyway, he's gone down. I've roached down with the rifle. Try and head him off going through the gully. On never bloody saw him, but I could hear him. He's gone up the other side there somewhere. So he was just down below me through here, and he's taken off. There's a scrape just behind that black boy down there, 30 metres away. You can see his marks in there, but I'll come back here this afternoon and have a look. He certainly wasn't, he didn't bolt off like he's got my scent, so I don't know what's spooked him. Surely he wouldn't have heard me talking on the, maybe he has. Anyway, you never know, you just never know. When you sit for a while in the bush, what's gonna come along? So it's probably only about 20 minutes after I've taken the shot, maybe half an hour after I've taken the shot, and it's probably only 150, 200 metres away. So the shot of the 9.3 didn't actually make any difference, really. That stag turned up like that. Put up another hind here. I'll come around the opposite side of the gully this afternoon to try and find that stag. He's probably three gully heads over on here. That's worth a look anyway. Well, that's it for today. I saw another hind, that was it. Deer are few and far between in here at the moment. I watched a very young calf. And hind, and then another hind. That was about 1:30 this afternoon. It's feeding, so yeah, that's about it.